Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Ganesh Kumar from India. Today, what we are going to see is introduction about Python. So, nowadays, the Python language is getting more and more familiar. Everywhere in all information and communication technology industries, they were trying to use this Python language is there for main projects. Today, this class, we are going to see that what is about a Python, what are all the features available, and what are all the different versions available, and what are the different flavors, how we can use this Python with any other software languages, and then we are going to see how we can able to write some small programs. First, we will see that it is a general purpose, high level programming language. By using this language, we can develop any kind of application in any environment. So why it is called it as an high-level programming language? When you compare, generally any programming language means we used to compare with C and Java. So when we compare with C and Java, how this Python programming language is going to get very easy to develop our projects? That is why we here mention it is a general purpose high-level programming language. We can develop any kind of applications. Who is the father of Python? Guido van Rossum. This is a person who has invented Python programming language in the year 1989. But officially, it has been declared in the year 1991, 20th February. Here, the major advantage is we need not to declare any data types. If you want to declare any data, then automatically our programming system itself, it will understand that this data belongs to integer, or it will belongs to float, or it belongs to any type of data. So automatically, which is going to detect what kind of data it is going to be. So the error is going to be dramatically, which is going to reduce. As I said, we used to compare with C and Java. So the C and Java programming language is a statically typed programming language, whereas in Python, dynamically typed programming language. Next, how this name has been given, this Python. In the year 1964 to 1974, in BBC, there is one very famous program which has been telecasted close to one decade. That program name was Monty Python Circus. So based on that, Guido van Rossum has given this Python name to this software. Now, we can see that there are two example programs here it has been given. The first example program and the second example program. So, we can easily write any kind of programs with the help of Python is very easy. For example, here in this first program, our objective is to print one single sentence. It means here, welcome to Python. If I want to do the same coding by using C or Java programming language, then it took at least 5 to 10 lines of coding. We need to include the header files, has include stdio.h and then getch, printch. There are a lot of statements we need to write it. Whereas in Python, if you see that, just print open bracket and within the double code, whatever we are going to type, all these things has been considered as a string automatically, which is going to print. That is welcome to Python. So automatically, this welcome to Python will be displayed. How easy it is. So anyone who knows English language, they can easily write programming in Python. Earlier those days, if you want to start your career in information and communication technology in any programming, we used to go with C, whereas now, if you are going to get into very first time in information communication in programming side, then Python is going to be a obvious choice. If you see the second program, if I want to declare the two datas and I want to add the two datas to get an output. For this program, if I want to write it in C, first I need to declare a two variables because I need to add a two datas, and then one more variable I need to store my results. Let us see the second program. I want to add the two numbers and I want to store it in a one more data. So if I am going to write the same program by using a C language, then the first step, I need to declare what are all the data types, and I need to declare the two variables. That two variables are A, what the data type, B is a what the data type, and the result is going to be the what data type. That I need to store it earlier, and then we need to include the header files, and we need to printing statements as well as get the data on the screen. Those statements we have to write. If the same program, if I want to write it in Python language, if you see that A comma 2 is equal to 10 comma 20, so automatically Python will understand that A is going to be a 10, A is assigned as a 10, B is going to assigned as a 20, and then the next statement, print A plus B. Automatically that A data and B data will be added, and then the results will be printed in the next line. So how easy it is, we can write the program in the Python language. Next, what are all the features in Python language? So the Python is a combination of lot of features available in multiple softwares. If you look at it here, the functional programming concept, it is a very famous concept and it is very useful concept that has been taken from C. And the object-oriented programming concept, which has been taken from the C++. And the scripting language concept has been taken from Perl and Shell script. And modular programming concept has been taken from the Modular 3. So the syntax has been taken from C and ABC languages. So this Python language, which is going to have the combination of functional, object-oriented programming, scripting, modular, and the syntax from the C and A plus B languages. So that by using Python, we can able to develop any kind of applications. What are all the applications we can develop? Where we can use this Python language? First example, we can take desktop applications. So even in desktop applications, as you see, very common applications, you can develop the calculator, you can develop a calendar, or if you develop a reminder, that kind of applications also easily we can able to develop by using an Python. And web-based applications we can develop. There are a lot of frameworks the Python is going to support. And the database applications also we can able to develop easily by using a Python. And networking applications we can develop. We can able to develop the gamings. We can develop our own gaming applications also done through this Python. And the most important applications by using a Python programming is, nowadays every industry is focusing on almost Internet of Things, Big Data, Machine Learning, and Artificial Intelligence. These are all the concepts which has been supported by the Python language. So data analytics, there is a huge data can be analyzed and we can able to inference the data. By means of machine learning, we can learn the pattern, and the artificial intelligence, how the human can take a decision, that decisions also the system can able to take with the help of Python language, and the natural language processing, and any type of IoT applications also we can develop by using Python programming languages. Next we see the different versions of Python. So starting from 1991, there are three versions so far: the Python version 1, Python version 2, Python version 3. In the Python version 1, which has been introduced in the year 1994 January, Python version 2 introduced in the year October 2000, Python version 3 December 2008. Here, one very important point is that the Python will never support the previous versions. Whatever the features in Python 3, it will never support the Python 2. It will never support the Python 1. There are some limitations in Python also. That limitations, only the two limitations which has been cited and more. The first one is the performance is low because it is an interpreter language. There is no need to compile. That is the reason why the performance is slightly low. That also can be overcome by adding some other features. And then mobile applications, it is not that much suitable to develop those kind of applications. There are different flavors of Pythons are available. It means that the Python can work with any good softwares. That means C Python, the C Python is, it will work along with the C language. So that is a standard level. It will work with C. JPython or Jython, that it will work along with the Java language. IronPython, which will work along with the C#. And PyPy, that is for to improving the speed. So the whatever the limitation which has been cited in the previous slide, that limitations has been overcome by PyPy. Here we can able to develop the Python virtual machines, that we call it as a PVM. And then Ruby Python will work along with Ruby on Rails, and Anaconda Python, which is going to be more and more useful for industrial purposes. It is going to handle the cloud and big data analytics. And then Stackless, which is going to support for a parallel execution and concurrency, so that we can increase the speed, we can overcome the limitations of the Python languages. So far, whatever we have seen about the Pythons and what are all the features available, where we can able to use, and the Python versions and the different flavors of Python. I hope you will enjoy this class. Thank you.